Welcome to Utah's Fly Corner. I'm going to show you how to tie a simple fur body ant. It's very old, dry fly pattern. You can fish them drowned, fish them dry on the top. Trout love ants, no doubt about it. Show you how to tie these guys. Real simple fly. I'll tie you a size 16. I like to use a light wire dry fly hook. I'm using Uni 8-0 Camel. Lay down a layer of thread. Bring it back over the bend slightly. I'm going to dub. Using super fine cinnamon dubbing. Make a cinnamon ant here. Red ant, as sometimes called. Now, key with the fur body ants, so you gotta dub this stuff on real nice and tight. I mean, that's the key with any dry fly. The dry fly dubbing that you use. Just dub it on nice and tight and very sparse amounts. Start my little bit back on the bend. And just lay down a layer of dubbing for as long as I want the rear part of it to be. That's about good. I don't like to have a huge rear part on the ant. I like to try to keep it relatively small. If you want to make them a little more rounded, you can, but I find that's a little true to form for the rear portion of an ant, particularly a carpenter ant, whether you have those in your area or not. I've never seen a red carpenter ant, but I shape them this way, and the trout seem to like them. Kind of dry fly feathers mixed up here. I'm going to be using a brown saddle hackle. You got to make sure that you leave yourself a space. It's just going to be thread on the shank. Tie your hackle in from the side. Wind. I'm using a whiting saddle hackle. You want to keep these guys sparse, so I dare not go any more than two turns. Catch your hackle in. Make sure it's tied down. The easiest way to get it to clip off is stand it up, wrap in front of it, stand those hackle fibers up, snip them. My hackle's at. I'm going to dub again to make the head. Like I said, this is a very simple and fast fly. Now with the head, you want it to be noticeably smaller than the rear part of the fly. Sorry, I don't know ant anatomy. I like to taper my heads. Getting a little lumpy with the dubbing there. Got a little loose on me. I like to taper the heads like that. Into a whip finish. Snip your thread. Now, you can leave it fully hackled like this, and it will catch fish. You can fish these babies drowned like this. They'll catch fish. But what I prefer to do, I turn her upside down, stroke up any hackle fibers that want to go up, and I snip them clean off the bottom, right flush against this. Right flush against. Then to protect the hackle stem, I like to put on a little bit of UV Looms UV clear fly finish. Just dab a little on that stem there, the hackle stem. Hit it with the light. And you got yourself an ant that even the most pickiest of trout will come up and gobble up. Well, that's the fur body ant. I'm Johnny Utah. Check me out on my blog, www.utahsflycorner.blogspot.com. I got lots of great information on there about flies, fly fishing. Come check it out. Sign up for Blogger and follow my blog. Would appreciate it. And please subscribe. Thank you.